Hi student,
in my last lecture I explained about information representation and codes part 1. This one is the part 2 because it is too much lengthy. I couldn't cover in a one video lecture. So this is the part 2. In this part 2 also I am going to explain about information representation and codes. In my last video lecture, what I shared, I want to give the brief explanation regarding my previous video lecture. Here, I discussed regarding what is a binary system, how you represent the binary information or binary system or binary numbers. Then I explained what is a decimal numbers, what is a base 10. Decimal numbers, also called base 10 number numeric environment or base 2 or binary environment. I also said how exact decimal numbers represent in a computer format. Exam means 16, and then we will use the number 0001. That means 4 bits together as a group will represent the number. So 4 bits we will use as a group to represent hexadecimal system. I explained that one also. And up to 9 we are following the 00001 like that. After 9 we are following the alphabets A equal to 10, B equal to 11, C equal to 12, D equal to 13, E equal to 14, and finally F equal to 15 and 16. So these are the binary information, binary numbers representation. So I also explained in my last class what is BCD. BCD is a converting decimal numbers into a binary equivalents. So now I want to explain a little more deeper regarding binary numbers, decimal numbers, and binary conversion to decimal numbers, and what are octal numbers, how to convert octal numbers into decimal numbers and binary numbers into decimal numbers. Because this conversion or converting one system to another system is very very important. In your examination the question will come. So last year examination also in computer organization architecture, there is a question that is convert binary numbers into decimal numbers, octal number to decimal number. That's why so studying of information representation and codes very very important. One thing is examination point of view or understanding of the information representation in a computer. So let's see about decimal number system. I already said what is a decimal numbers. A decimal number is made of digits. A digit takes the value between 0 to 9. So in decimal number system you are taking the value 0 to 9. 0 to 9 any number we can use to represent the data. Number system represent values numbers with respect to its given base. Each of the digit is multiplied by its weight, which is 10 to the power of 0. For the first digit from the right one, for the second digit, second for the third digit, etc. So we will see this one in little manner. So this is the number representation. 10 power 0, 10 power 1, 10 power 2, 10 power 3, 10 power 4. So these are the decimal positions. So ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, I hope that in your childhood, already knows the number system, especially we are following the decimal number system. First one is the ones place, and second one is the tens place, and third one is the hundreds place, fourth one is the thousands place, fifth one is the 10,000s, and sixth one is lakh, and seventh one is 10 lakhs, eighth one is crores. Like that, the decimal, based on the position, the value will depend. Just look at here, one question is given, that is 243. So 243, how you will represent the data? Simple, 3 in a ones position, 4 in a tens position, 2 in a hundred position. 2 in a 100 positions, then now 2 become a 200, 4 in a tens position, that 4 become a 40, 3 in a ones position, 3 become a only 3. So now add 200 plus 40 plus 3, then it will become 243. So based on the position of the value, okay, the based on the position, the number will get the actual value. Actual value. So this is called zeros, ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, like that. This position is called decimal positions. So I want use the pen to representing a ones place, again tens place, again hundred place. After hundred, thousands will come. After thousand, 10,000 will come. Okay, this way of number system we call decimal number system. Then we will see after decimal numbers, I want to talk about octal number. Octal, the meaning of octal, this one also comes from the Greek language. Octal means in the Greek, 8. 8 means octal. So octal numbers represent the base 8. I already said base 2 represent binary numbers, base 10 represents decimal numbers, base 16 represents hexadecimal numbers, and now we are talking about octal numbers. The base of the octal number is 8. So octal number system is one the type of number representation techniques in which the is their value of base is 8. That means there are only 8 symbols or possible digit values. There are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are the 0 to 7 only. So if it is a decimal, the representation of the data, we are using the value, digit values 0 to 9 in decimal system. If it is an octal system, we are using the digital values 0 to 7 only. Please remember 0 to 7 only. When you are talking about the decimal, we are using the number 0 to 9. 0 to 9, there are 10 positions are there. At the same time, when you are talking about the octal, here 0 to 7, again 8 positions are there. So these digit values represent octal number system. Each octal number can be represented using only 3-bit. Students, I said in hexadecimal number system, each number can be represent using 4 bits. In hexadecimal, we are using the 4 bits. Okay. If you are using the same number system, in octal, we are using 3 bits only, not 4 bits, 3 bits only. Sir, what is the meaning of bits, sir? Bits are nothing but the positions, combination of the position. In hexadecimal, 4 places to combine together or represent together, or combination of the 4 places represent the hexadecimal numbers. Now the combination of 3 positions, we can say that 3 bits. 1 bit is equal to 1 position. So 3 positions means 3 bit combination will represent the octal numbers. Okay, just we want to write 0 in an octal number system. What we will write? locate here 0 0 0. 3 times we have to write the 0, then it will become a 0. We won't write the 1 in an octal system and then 1 1 1 1. So for 7 equal to 4 plus 2 plus 1. So this is the equivalent binary number of octal number as given below. So now see, so I hope that you understand the what is a octal number. Octal number represented by a 3-bit combination. So now I want to talk about some mathematical operations on octal numbers. Here our task is to convert octal to decimal. As previously we have seen how binary converting binary to decimal, and we can see how octal can convert to decimal. These questions will come, damn sure. We'll see. Now I am talking about converting octal to decimal. Let's take that 275 from octal to decimal, okay? 275 from octal to decimal. Now 275 is the octal number. Now you want convert this 275 into decimal number. Steps we have to follow. The first step that we have to follow, write down the place of value of each digit. So previously I already explained 1's position, 10's position, 100 position, 1000 position. The same manner 275, just write down the place value of each digit. Place value of 5 place, 7 place, 2 place. Okay. The second step that we have to follow, add up the place value of each digit. First we have to write down in their respective places. Then what we have to do, we have to add up based on this place values. Look at here. So here 275, just what I did, just write down the place of each digit. 5, it is in first place. 7, it is in second place. 2, it is in third place. So in first place, from your following right to left, you're following right to left. How you're following the decimal numbers, the same way you're following the right to left. Now look at here. So 80, 8 power 1, 8 square. So 5, it is in a 1's place, and 7, it is in a 8 power 1 place, and 2, it is in a 8 power 2 place. Just 8 power 0 equal to 1, and 8 power 1 equal to 8, and 8 square is equal to 64. Now what we have to do, we have to do, now just you write down the, we are writing the values, place values. What you did, you are writing place values. All of you look at here, 275. Our problem here is to convert octal number into decimal number. What is the octal number? 275, it is the octal number. What we have to do here, just convert the 275 into decimal number. You know the actual value of 275 equal to decimal value. What is that equal decimal value? That the thing what you are doing now. So first thing, just you are dividing the places, place values. Just you write down, we are just you are writing the place values 5, 7, 2, and just you are adding with the their square number power, and just what to do, just you are multiplying with this power and adding their places, digit places. Now look at here, 275 divided 8 power 0, 8 power 1, 8 square. Okay, what is the 8 power 0 value? 1. In one position, what is the number? 5. Okay, just 5. Then plus, then 8 power 1. 8 power 1 value in decimal, 8. Okay, just 7 into 8. Then again, so next 8 square or 8 power 2. In 8 power 2, what is the value? What is the value of 8 power 2? 64. So now 64 into 2. Okay, 64 into 2 plus
8 into 7 plus 1 into 5. So 64 into 2, 128 plus 8 into 7, 56 plus 1 into 5, 5. Totally 189. So what we have to observe here, so octal value of 275 equal to 189. Octal value of 275 equal to 189. That we have to understand. So what we are doing, we did here, just converting octal, it is 275 into decimal, that is 189. This process is called converting to decimal, octal converting to decimal. Okay, I hope that question will come. Convert the octal number into decimal number, or convert the decimal number into octal number, or convert the binary number into decimal number, or convert the decimal number into binary number. It's a very, very important question. So it will come in your examination. I hope that you understand this concept clearly. So we'll go for the next concept. So next concept about binary system. Already I discussed regarding binary system in my previous lecture. Again, I want to give the one example in a binary to decimal. Till now we discussed how to convert octal to decimal. Now I am going to talk about how binary to decimal, how number convert binary to decimal. Important question, please understand. These are very, very important. One is octal to decimal or binary to decimal. Okay, it may ask decimal to octal or octal to decimal. It may ask binary to decimal or decimal to binary. Okay, it is with both are very easy process. Okay, now let's look at here. So binary, all know about the binary numbers, yes or no? You know about all the binary numbers. What are the binary numbers? 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So any number that forms through using of the 0 or 1, this system, number system, we call binary number system. In binary number system, apart from the 0, 1, no number will be there. Just here one number is given. So this number, the value of this number is 1111 0011, 1111 0011. This is the actual value of number. Now what we have to do here, this binary number, what is the binary number? This is the binary number. Okay, this is the main number, will convert into decimal. How you convert the decimal? Simply, so what you did in the octal, just based on the position, this is the first position, the second position, third position, fourth position, fifth position, sixth position, like that. So what you have to do now, just we have to, based on the positions, so we have to multiply and add it. Okay, first one, 1 star 1, this is the one position, so multiply with 1. Second position, 1 star 2, okay. So you multiply this one with the, just look at here, up, look at here, upside, look at upside. See here how to convert first 2 power 0, then 2 power 1, then 2 power 3, then 2 power 4, then 2 power 5, then 2 power 6, then 2 power 7. So this is the actual binary number system. So binary number system, and below of that number 2 power 0 value equal to 1. This is the way how we have to write. First 2 ke upar 0 lagana hai, uske baad 2 ke upar 1 lagana hai, uske baad 2 ke upar 2 lagana hai, uske baad 2 ke upar 4 lagana hai, uske baad 2 ke upar 8 lagana hai, uske baad 2 ke upar 16 lagana hai. Matlab ye number previous numbers se multiply jaakar aisa ho jayega. So actually converting first number, so based on the this position, according to that we have to write in the two powers. First position we have to write in the first position equal to 2 power 0, second one equal to 2 power 1, third one equal to 2 power 2, and fourth position equal to 2 power 3, fifth position equal to 2 power 4, Okay, like that we have to write from left to from left to here. Okay, this side to this side. We have write from this side to this side. That we have to understand. We have to write from this side to this side. That's very important. Where we have to write? We have to write from this side to from where to where? From this side to that side. So, and what you have after adding up 2 power 0, what is the 2 power 0 value? 2 power 0 equal to 1, okay, 1. In what position 1 is there? Anything 1 or 0 will be there. 1 position 1 is there, so 1 into 1 plus next 2 power 1. What is the 2 power 1 value? 2. So 2 into here second position 1 again 1 is there, 2 power 1, okay, plus I am go for the third position value 8. Okay, 8 into in third position, what is the value in a binary system? 0. So 8 into 0, 0. Like that, we have to add the all position. So what number will come? That is the decimal number. So here decimal number 11. So 11111001. This is the binary number. This binary number equal to 243. 243. This binary number equal to 243. So look at here. 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. Here we are not adding all. So which position it has 1? So 0 will become a 0. 1 will become that 1 into the particular position number. So look at here. That's why I am telling all of you, look at the figure carefully. So here positions are given. Where the 0, 0 multiply with that number, when the 0 into 8 become 0. Again, 0 into 4 become 0. Again, only especially 2 zeros are there. So this position, 2 positions are 0, remaining are adding the total. Then what is the answer here? 243 is the answer. This is the actual process how you are converting binary number to decimal number and octal number to decimal number. These are very, very important question. Now I am going to talk about so till now we have seen about number system in a computer, number system. Now we are going to talk about test representation. Till now what we have seen? Till now we are discussing regarding of numeric numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It may be binary numbers, it may be octal numbers, it may be hexadecimal numbers, decimal numbers. We have a talk regarding these all number systems. Now, if you want to represent the data in a computer, data means what? A, B, C, D, or words, or sentences, or paragraphs. So these are the actual alphabets. So if you want to write any test in the computer, how computer can understand it? So how can it understand it? Simply, so how computer can understand the test? So for understanding of the test, the computer systems or designers following the ASCII, especially here if you want to say totally here, Total five systems are there to understand the test representation of data in a computer. What are the five? We are going to discuss only a particular test representation among the five. So what is that? That is very, very important. ASCII representation. What is the ASCII? We will see. So first of all, we have to understand it. That is, we can represent test data in a five ways, but among the five ways, so very, very important one is ASCII code. What is that? ASCII code. We will discuss regarding of ASCII code. First, look at how many test representations are there. There are five test representations are there. First one is ASCII, American Standard Code for Information Interchange. ASCII means very, very important students. ASCII is very, very important that we are following in a computer system for what? Code system for test representation, not the numeric value representation, but test representation. ASCII American, ASCII means
American standard code for information interchange. And next one is the extend ASCII, the second type of test representation. And third one is EBCDIC, extend coded decimal interchange code. Extend coded decimal interchange code. This one also we are using for test representation. Unicode, universal code. This one also we are using for what? Test representation. The finally ISO, International Organization for Standardization. International Organization for Standardization. This one also we are using for test representation. These are the five types that we are using for test representation in a computer. Among these five, so ASCII is very familiar. American standard code information interchange. That is the actual definition of ASCII. I want to talk about ASCII, American Standard Coding Information Interchange. So, stand for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. The code uses 7 bits to encode 128 unique characters. So, in a computer and a keyboard, totally 128 unique characters are there. These unique characters, the code uses 7 bits. 7 bits to encode. You all of you know about the encoding and decoding and going to study about in the forthcoming Udo classes what is encoding and what is decoding. So as a note, a formally worked to create his code began in 1960, first standard in 1960 and last updated in 1986. So dear student, please try to understand here, the American standard code for information interchange, so it is for what? It is for understanding the test data or represents the test data in a computer. Sir, all you may ask the doubt, sir, computer can understand only binary data, that is zeros and ones. So while you are typing the ABCDs, how computer understanding this high level language, sir, this ABCDs, sir, simple, whatever it may be, it can understand only zeros and ones, but in between there is a translator. So using the translator to translate the this one, how the translating simple ASCII value. ASCII value generating the different 010101 code. So ASCII value actually it will generate the some codes. I will show you. This is the actual, when you are typing some data, when you are typing ABCDs, so what we will do now, ASCII will interchange the data. Okay, information interchange the data, just encoding. What is encoding? Just look at here, 123. 123 is the number. Okay, then 123. What is 123? Just it will convert the numbers. Now that these are 7-bit codes. These are 7-bit code. 01001. Okay. 010001. The 7-bit code. So Joane. So 100101010111 and 100001. So 110 110 110 110 110 110. This is the encoding. So while you are typing the data, the ASCII code convert the data into a particular coding system, encoding system. That is called, when you are typing the A, it will generate the one number. That is, it may be 0101 or 1001. Then one generate the one, this type of number. Then computer can understand what is the 1001. So that is the call. It will done by the ASCII. So ASCII means American Standard Code of Information Interchange. This is the actual duty of the ASCII. Just it will generate the code for machine understanding. So finally, I want to sum up all these things. In a summary, first we discussed regarding human perception. Finally, I want to conclude and I want again summarize it. Human perception, humans can understand only decimal numbers. Computer can understand only binary numbers. This is that you are following the some procedures that is called binary, decimal, octal, hexadecimal. This all process to make the computer understand the number systems. So that we have seen in this video lecture. Then I explained about BCD,
binary converted code or binary converting decimals, binary converted decimals. So how we did the operations, just adding up 3 plus 3, adding up the 4 plus 1, adding up the pi plus plus that we have seen. And that one hexadecimal representation and octal decimal representation. How to convert the binary to octal, octal to binary. So these are things what we have to discuss. So my dear students, very, very important lecture. So please, please go through this video lecture and prepare well, study well. If you have any doubt, we'll discuss in our online interaction class. So thank you so much.